Good morning, children. Let us start the next lesson. The name of the lesson is We Are All Unique. The lesson is all about between an elephant and the owl. The name of the elephant is Alice and the name of the owl is Usha. So the lesson is all about these two animals. Let us see what will happen in the lesson. But before that, let us read some hard words. The first one is unique. Cities, intelligent, activities, proud, extracurricular, announced, chief guest, navigator. The last one is victorious. So these are the hard words from the lesson. Now let us go to the lesson. In a jungle far away from cities and villages, there lived a young elephant named Alice. She went to school run by the intelligent Mr. Fox. Alice was very good in extracurricular activities, but she was proud and mean and said to Usha, "Hey Usha, you don't study all day to pass the exams." Alice said to Usha, the owl, "You are only going to get a bigger pair of glasses." Usha made fun of studying a lot. She was a very good student but lagged behind the sports and other extracurricular activities. Mr. Fox knew how proud Alice was. He wanted to help her become a good person. So he thought of a plan to make Alice value the worth of others. Mr. Fox announced that this time there would be a team race on sports day. Each would have two animals. One would run while the other would navigate the route for the runners. Alice and Usha were put in the same team. "With that owl in my team, I'm going to lose for sure," said Alice. Usha, on the other hand, was nervous for being picked for race, and that too as Alice's partner. "Alice will be very mean to me if we don't win," she cried. On the day of the race, both Alice and Usha set their feet on the track nervously. The navigators placed themselves on the runners with maps in their hands. The navigators were lighter animals and the runners were strong and fast. Alice saw that she was up against Tinu the tiger, Lina the leopard, Jack the jackal, and the other fast runners. She could not see how she would beat these runners, and to top it all, she had little trust in Usha. The king of the jungle, Mr. Leo, had been invited as the chief guest. He gave a loud roar and the race started. As soon as Usha heard the roar, she dropped the map and flew upwards. Alice yelled after her, "Don't leave me, you coward." "I'm not leaving you. I have memorized the map. I can guide you from above and warn you of hurdles before other navigators can see them," replied Usha. Alice did as Usha told her, and they survived all the hurdles one after the other. The other runners did not have as intelligent a navigator as Usha, so they were slowed down by the hurdles. At the end of the race, Alice and Usha stood victorious. Everyone congratulated the duo and greeted them with cheers. "I'm sorry, I was so mean to you. You are a lot better than I am." "You won us the race," said Alice. "No," said Usha. "We won as a team. And we are not better or worse than each other. We are unique in our own way." From that day onwards, Usha and Alice became best friends. So what you can learn from the story, children, the moral of the story is that we should not underestimate anyone saying that what this person or that person will do. We must understand that they will do according to their plan and opinions and depends on their own ability and capacity. That's how the lesson itself says, we are all unique. So this is a lesson, children. Let us go to the meanings. The first one is extracurricular. Things or activities that are done besides studies. Next, navigate, to direct the way to reach a given point. Next, hurdles, difficulties. Victorious, someone who has achieved victory. Next, unique, very unusual. So those are the meanings that you have in the lesson. Next part of the grammar we have is rhyming words, where you have to find the word which pronounce the same rhyme, the pronunciation. First one is fair, chair. Next, lean, bean. Next, gap, tap. Like this, you have three more rhyming words. You can do it by yourself on your own. Next section, we have the fill in the blanks with the help of the hint box. They have already given you the answers in the hint box. You just have to pick up the correct word and write in the blank wherever it is necessary. Usha has a dash talent, unique. Next, Roma is an dash girl, intelligent. Next, I was dash before the exams, nervous. So like this, you have three more blanks you can write on your own by looking at the hint box. Part of the lesson that we have is question and answers from the lesson. The first question, what was the name of the young elephant? The name of the young elephant was Alice. Next, why did the other animals make fun of Usha? Usha was made fun of for studying a lot. Next, why were Usha and Alice upset after hearing about the race? Alice was upset because she thought she would lose. Usha was nervous for being picked as Alice's partner in the race. Next, who was invited as the chief guest for the race? Mr. Leo was the chief guest for the race. Name the animals against whom Alice and Usha were competing. Usha and Alice were competing against Tinu, the tiger, Lena, the leopard, Lena, the leopard, Jack, the jackal, and the other fast runners. Next, why did Usha fly off, leaving Alice on the ground? Usha flew so that she could guide Alice from above and warn her of hurdles. Next, last one, who won the race? Usha and Alice won the race. These are the question and answers you have in the lesson. Next, read the following lines carefully and identify the speakers. You just have to understand the sentence and then write who spoke to whom. You are only going to get a bigger pair of glasses. This was said by Alice. Next, with that owl in my team, I'm going to lose for sure. Again, Alice. This sentence was told by Alice. I'm not leaving you, Usha. We won as a team and we are not better or worse than each other. We are unique in our own way. This was said by Usha. The next part of the grammar that we have is again different kind of fill in the blanks where you have to write the correct adverbs from the hint box. You have to write the correct adverbs. The first one is John walks slowly. John walks slowly. Next, I will go to see him tomorrow. Next, the thief entered the house quietly. So these are the blanks we have in the lesson, children. The next part, the next section we have is the punctuation marks, where you have to write in the sentence. Are the following sentences statements or questions? Find out and put correct punctuation at the end of the sentences. The punctuations are nothing but you just need to write the symbols like question mark symbol, full stop, or inverted commas, commas, and exclamatory marks. All these signs will come under punctuation mark. The first one is she reading? It's a question. You just have to write the symbol as question mark, put at the end of the sentence. Next one is Montu is playing with his friends. It is a complete sentence. Wherever you see a complete sentence, you just have to put full stop. That is called the complete sentence. Next, that is a blue bottle. It is also a complete sentence. You just have to put full stop there. Now, this is the lesson, children. Hope you understood it. Thank you, children.